just saw some turkeys on the side of the road. What is Gucci, my dudes? My name is 11M Gamer. Welcome back to our video. In today's video, we're out here in the middle of literally nowhere. There is nothing. As far as the eye can see, there's nothing out here. We're in the middle of nowhere. But, we came all the way out here so my sister could buy a stupid horse, so, she's sitting over there, my parents. I heard it stepped on Summer's foot.
Yeah.
It's not broken or anything.
Those other horses walked out there. She wants to go with them.
She did fine. She really doesn't trip. And I'm like, you just have to.
The brown one, you have to run and jump.
Alright guys, the weather has gotten a bit better. It's actually really nice out here now. It's about probably 65-70. It's pretty nice out here in the middle of nowhere, but back to the car. Oh, Tank! These guys, they have cows out here, and Tank's been going absolute mental for the last hour. God, Tank, chill, Bill. Alright guys, on the way here we had to make a quick pit stop because my dad, he knows these people. There's a lot of cool stuff in here. Is that Justin's car?
Yeah. It's illegal to sell 383 stroker.
Alright, we're here in Lowe's. We're gonna return the tool that we bought. The one that broke. There it is, right there. There's the tool broke right there. So we're gonna see how that goes.
So I bought this.
Okay. Interesting combination. I'm gonna put 30 cents back on the fee.
Broke. Yeah.
I'm gonna give you 50.
Right here, this thing.
For $50.
This here.
Okay. Well, we want another one.
But we want another one.
Halfway done.
Yeah. We want another one. We don't want our money.
Okay.
So you want us to go get one?
Yeah, if you want, you can just go grab a replacement and bring it back up here and we can help you.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
That was pretty easy. Little Tank's just chilling. Look at this awesome screwdriver I just found, right? So, let me see here, Summer, can you hold this up? Like that. So when you turn the bit like this, it's a ratcheting bit. So you turn it like this, and it goes both ways. See? It doesn't stop turning. Like that, see? Yeah, it's got like, let's say, 35 different bits. All them bits, look at all them bits. Bits for days.
There we go, guys.
$39.
Yeah. That's it.
What is that? What is that? What?
Oh my gosh.
How does that work? What is it for?
Nicely.
You ready?
So it goes on the back and you can scoot your dryer.
It goes in the wall.
It'll go in the wall.
Oh, so it doesn't bend the hose. You have to bend the hose around.
You want to get that nail?
Goes on the outside of the wall, so it's not going to matter.
Okay, babe.
I just need to know.
JB, what was that?
Is it like a place?
Alright, we're after JB Wells. It's on aisle 7, so we're going to look for it. I don't think I see it anywhere. Alright, we got two different things. We got Loctite, JB Weld. We're gonna see which one works the best.
$33. It's not bad, right?
Yeah. How's it going? We got the stuff. Got some Loctite. Got some JB Weld. Got a battery. Then we got the stuff that you guys got.
Or took it.
Alright guys, so we're in Lowe's and we were looking at refrigerators for the kitchenette, little mini fridges. I just came up with this great idea. I was thinking whenever we get my office built and all done and everything, later down the road, we could take the mini fridge that is in the garage and move it into my office. That'd be so cool. So leave down in the comments below what you think of that idea. Alright, of course we're going to pick out our light bulb. They have out of stock, we gotta get them.
How many of them do you need?
All three.
Alright guys, we got the goods. Picked out a lighting set, some awesome bulb thing covers.
No, you'll have to just page her, sorry. Bye.
Then we're gonna try and exchange the tool here.
Here's our tool to replace the one that I broke last week.
Would it be this one?
Alright, we went and got all the stuff out of Lowe's. We only got a battery. And what else did we get? I'm trying to think. We got a battery for the yellow jacket, and we got some JB Weld for the selfie stick. Yeah. And then we got a light piece that's a free socket light thing for our bathroom in the basement. And then we also got, I can't figure out what else, I can't remember. But anyways, we got some stuff closed for the house and such. So I don't know where we're going. We're going right now, but whenever we get there, I'll see you guys then. Alright guys, we went and got picked up some dinner or some lunch at the deli here. Got some, so we got. Got some, oh dear, got some chicken, got some ice cream, got some potatoes, got some Salisbury steak, good to go. Alright guys, we're going to go ahead and head out in the shop and work on the yellow jacket. The battery's kind of dead, so much, I don't know how much time we'll actually have to record. My battery's kind of getting dead, so I got the tripod and I'll meet you guys out there. Sorry for the wind noise in the background, it's really windy today. Look on the map, it's supposed to be 40 mile an hour winds all day today. Let's go ahead and get out to the garage here. Let's try the wind zone. Oh! That's better. Listen. No wind noise. Alright guys, so real quick, there's this spooky door shut. I want to show you guys, I'm not trying to rub it in your face like, oh, I put all this work, whatever. I'm showing you guys the amount of dedication I put in to my videos. So you guys can have the best of the best. You got a light here, light there, just to get the good angle. Because without all this lighting, it's really dark in here. Like, I just want to show you guys the amount of dedication I put into all my videos and all the work that I do on this channel. I really do try my best to make it the best for you guys, the viewers. So, I'm not doing that to like rub it in your face, what I'm just saying. But this isn't something that's not just all about me. It's about the viewers too, I try my best, so. Alright, so I don't know how much battery we have. I'm trying to hurry and go the quickest I can so we don't run completely out of juice. On me battery here, mate. So, first, we're gonna get the old battery out. So I'm gonna use this magical tool here and cut these as close as possible because I don't want to have to replace any wire. Man, they're hard. Darn. That's some tough wire. Oh, man. Holy bejesus. Oh, holy crap. Alright, that crap. Get out of here, trash. Next one. Oh, okay, that's out of there. Now get the battery out. Now I would suggest using some kind of towel or something. Because you don't want to get, if the battery does leak, you don't want to get battery acid on yourself. That stuff is not the best for your health overall. So, it's like rotted in there. It's like stuck. That's insane. Oh God. So much junk. Oh God, that's a heavy mother trucker, dude. Mother trucker, dude, that hurt like a butt cheek on a stick. That old battery out. Now we're gonna get the new battery, which it's still over there. Let me grab it. I gotta get it. All right. Now, which we put this in? I put it in like this. Yeah, that sounds good. Alright. I'm so unsure of everything. I don't know why. Ugh. Look at that. Like a glove. Like a glove. Is that going to cause problems with the seat? Possibly. Alright, no problem. We'll just flip her around. That's the other direction. So we don't completely kill everything. I'm gonna let it arc out of the seat here. Should be fine. What could go wrong, am I right? I guess the question is, what could go right? Alright, so now what you're gonna wanna do is strip some new ends off on your battery. I don't know if you can see this or not. If you can't, I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. Get this out of here. These strippers will strip it. Ooh. RKO. It's another one. Oh. Just barely, dude. Alright, so then, take some of these ends here. I need to figure out, we're gonna use these little ones right here for the positive and negative. Just gonna put this, oh, that could be a problem. Oh dear. That could be a big problem. What am I gonna do? The hole is like, let's say not scale, hole's this big, cable's this big, now I gotta fit it. We're gonna have to find some different leads, and then I'll get back to you when we find some different leads. Alright, we'll get back to you. Alright guys, so I kind of found a solution for my problem. One of these would work. You guys see the holes big enough, you can crimp them down. But these are for copper, and I'm pretty sure they're pretty expensive. They're for like solder and stuff and such. So we're gonna use what my dad wanted me to use, but what you're gonna have to do, you're gonna have to cut some of your wire away, because it won't all fit into the same hole. You know what I'm saying? So like that right there, that's enough. So the rest of this, we can just cut it off like that. And just watch your eyes. Because little pieces of copper could go like flying in your eyeball. And anything besides eye juice in your eyeball is not good. So don't do that. So once you get that like fixed or whatever, you're going to want to go ahead and put one of these ends onto your fitting thingy. Push it on there real tight. Take your crimpers and crimp them on there super tight. Because if you don't, you could done goof. And then there you go, you done goof basically. Remember, that's rubber. You want to frick. Okay, so you want to crimp them not there where I just did. Mother trucker, dude. Alright, let's try that again. You want to crimp it where there's metal. Right here, not back here. So, like, put them on there and everything.
and push it on there really super tight. And then you're gonna have to like crimp them on there then like this. Not with the cut side either. Darn, dude. Oh, mother checker, dude. Oh, Jesus Christ. If those comes off, like, I don't know why they would, but they better not. Because, like, those were hard to crimp, my dudes. Holy bejesus. They were some tough cookies. Just keep crimping them down until you think they're on there pretty tight. Which, you know, they are. Jesus, bro. Bro, dude. My guy. Okay. Positive. It's on there. Not that side. Oh, crap. This could be our problem. It's the wrong battery. This could be a problem. Because this is not long enough to reach over there. So, I know how to fix this. I'll be back with you guys in a second. Alright guys, so the problem is we ran into a dilemma here. This is the wrong battery. Because if you put it, if you switch it around so the positive is closer back, you can see the wires. It won't, this positive wire won't reach. It's too short, we need it from here to here. So, if you turn it around, you shut the seat down, it'll arc out in this middle strip, and it'll hurt, like, a lot. So, like, we're gonna put some, I found these leads, we're gonna set the other one. Oh, bejesus. Here's the other one, here's the little spice thingy. I found some leads in the back of my dad's shop, and these leads, they have the correct ends and everything. Right here, see? That you put onto the battery. They're all heat shrinking, all mice and stuff. That we can use to extend this side. This side's good. I can do this side. This side I can't. So we're gonna cut them here. I got some splices, and we're gonna make that good. So I'll get back to you guys when we get that done. All right, guys. So once you get your lines all ready to go, this one's ready. This one's ready. Go ahead and take your bolt, some little washer on this side, and a washer on the other side. Bolt here, this is your ground, but don't mix them up. Don't be that guy that mixes up the two cables and breaks stuff. Don't be that guy, please. Just please, like I'm asking myself, don't be that guy. Put your bowl on there. Sorry if you can't see, I have fat hands, deal with it. Savage. Let's see here. Things on here. Do 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 do. Alright, make sure you don't touch both your wrenches to both terminals the same side. Cause it's gonna spark, and sparks are cool and all, but when sparks hurt, they become instantly less cool. Because it will hurt. Being electrocuted by a battery, it's gonna hurt. Like, I don't know from personal experience, but it's just gonna hurt. So don't be that guy. Once again, don't be that guy. I figured out that the hard way. Put it on there, super, super tight. It's not gonna move. Go ahead and get the next one. The next one is the positive, so make sure your key is turned to the off position, which I have not done. Make sure it's on the off position, so when you connect them, it doesn't spark, because there's only power. Electricity stuff, trying to sell smart stuff. Get your bolt. Put a washer on both sides. Now, if you bought the correct battery, none of this would need to happen, but we didn't know, like, what battery it needed. So, like, don't judge me, please. I beg you. Please. Washer on. Put the nut on there. Once again, do not touch these two together at the same time like that. Don't. Just don't. Like, it's not that difficult. Just don't do it. Like, don't hurt yourself. Those two all good to go on there. Really tight. And we're putting lock nuts on there so they don't vibrate off and like hurt bad. So like do that too. Like they're just like normal nuts and bolts and stuff, except they're like better. Cause they don't vibrate off, they have little pieces of rubber inside that keep that thing from happening. So once you get it all done, like clean up your workspace. I like to electrical tape the connections that I made with the batteries, with the posts, so they don't completely like get ruined. So wrap them in electrical tape. There is liquid electrical tape, which I think is really cool, a lot easier, but it's like, it gets everywhere, so like we're not gonna make a mess. We're gonna cut a whole battery liquid electrical tape. Now, I do have this paint stuff that you spray on your battery terminals to keep them from like corroding and stuff like that. So I do recommend using that because like on the old battery, it's all corroded and ugly and such. You don't want that because like if you get this stuff on your clothes, it will like eat through your clothes. So you don't want that, I don't think. And also it's like better for your battery. Like trying to sound like I know what I'm talking about. So don't do that. Get your new battery all in. You should probably, it could be the best thing to like if you get a new phone, kind of like that, to charge it before you like go ahead and start it up and crank on it and everything. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. We're gonna charge it for a little bit. If I could find the battery charger, like that'd be a plus if I could do that. But my battery's gonna die, so I'm gonna do my intro here. Turn this around. Oh god. Don't forget to check out my Twitter, Instagram links are in the description. If you like that video, give it a big thumbs up. And if you're new around here, hit that subscribe button. If you're, yeah, like let's aim for like 5 likes in this video. Like, that'd be great. I'm gonna grab my second camera and record if it starts or not. So, we'll see you guys next week. Peace.
Too low.
Alright guys, we had to, it wouldn't start for a minute there, so we had to call in an ASC certified mechanic, and we determined that the battery is not putting out enough power to start it, so we jumped it from our Suburban and the battery charger, and I think my camera just broke. It's just zooming in by itself. Okay, there it stopped. That was weird. And now it runs really good now if you start it up. We got it all running now, and
good for $50.
Yeah, and how much was the battery? Like 30. 32. So what?
Less than $100.
What are you doing? Yeah, triggered. Okay.
Yes.
It's empty.
Yes, we'll get it going.
It's empty. So, it needs a new back tire, and we're going to put a car battery on it, and put an alternator on the bottom. So, leave down in the comments below some ideas of what we should do to it all.
Straight pipe exhaust.
No, everyone calls the cops around here.
Straight pipes.
Police. Okay. Alright, so we'll get back to you guys in the next video. Peace.
Hey, what are you doing down there?
Working on my mowing deck. Taking it off.
Hey guys, this is 11M Gamer, and looks to me like he's working on a lawnmower, and he is the yellow jacket. And I think he's taking the mowing deck off. So we're gonna watch it. Got both of them.
Take a little nap. So.
Chuck, do these come off?
Oh my gosh.
I don't know if we can work out of this.
I see where the belt's supposed to go.
Can you undo these right here?
Let me see the light without it being in my eyes. Looks like most of that crap will stay up there. Yeah, it's real simple. It just unpins.
Okay. There's no belts hooked up to it because the belt's messed up.
Oh, that's like a 2 second. So go over there.
Right here?
Yeah, just pull that out. It's kind of tough.
Okay, I don't want to. Are you filming?
Jiggle it and pull it out.
I get some pliers, I think. That clip comes out again. I grab some pliers.
There's like some little nipples on there that has to line up a little bit.
Oh, I see. I think.
Yep, just like that.
There
it goes. Keep on pulling. Nothing's gonna happen. Keep on pulling.
Now what comes undone?
What's this right here?
Hooked up to. Can you get down here
while
we're working
out?
I got it. Right there, he's looking at that.
That cable goes on there.
So
now we got that undone.
Okay. Now I've got to pull it forward to get those rods up here from front.
Yeah, now you just go forward up off.
Okay, I let go on one side. That was really easy.
Two-minute decker mobile system. Look at that! It's pretty simple, huh? Okay, drag that junk out of there.
Okay, so I want to look while we're doing it. How are we going to
go
over there?
Why don't you get that out of there and then we can get underneath there and see.
Okay, pause.
Here, let's lay underneath here on top of the...
Okay, now we're working back over here, though.
Okay, so it worked out pretty good, right?
Yeah, we're working back over here.
Okay, so
my favorite kind of cheese.
Goat cheese?
No, queso.
Queso?
He said queso.
Where'd you come up with queso cheese?
He said queso. Queso.
Queso.
Queso cheese.
Well, there's the pulley right there, the front one.
Okay.
Drive, and then it comes back here. Oh no, look at that belt.
Oh Jesus.
Look at it. I'm surprised that thing even pulled it anywhere.
Holy bejesus.
Yeah, so we're going to take that belt off.
Okay, and do we make...
belt.
So that pulley in the back, do you make it bigger or smaller to make the pulley swap?
You make the one in the back smaller.
And the one in the front bigger.
And the one in the front bigger.
She should be able to switch them, right? You should.
Well, I don't know.
It might just work.
That sounds real easy in theory. I mean, everybody always thinks that stuff's real easy until they start doing it. That's why mechanics are the doers and the people are the... Yeah, that's real easy. Let's just do that.
So what do you hook the alternator on to... Which one would you do that for?
We'll run it off of this right here.
Because you want to be able to disengage it and engage it, right? You said?
No, we can just let it run full time.
Okay, so you can take all this out, right?
Yeah, we should be able to take all that garb out, including that arm that goes up there, up the steering column. You're not going to use that, right? No.
So we might use that when we do the slab shifter conversion.
The what?
I already said, yes. I'm going to make a playlist public to you guys, video ideas that I had for this mower.
Well, we ain't doing no slab shifter. That just sounds like something's going to get tore up right away.
No.
Here, let me slap you.
I'll have to send him. He has no one seen the plans before. It's like super secret.
Okay, so.
Cheese.
Oh my gosh, cheese and rice. So it looks like this whole bracketry system right here is what holds that on. What's all them pedals over there for?
This is the speed.
Speed?
This is the brake.
What does that do? What's that supposed
makes
to do?
Makes it go faster and slower.
Really?
Yeah, and it's locked because the brake is on right here. This is the brake.
Well, let the brake off and see what that does, actually.
Okay.
Okay. Well, that just tightens up that belt. When you get that, I don't understand how that can make it go faster. I think that's what, to drive it. You push that in to drive it.
I have no clue.
Because if you put it in gear and everything, it's just going to sit here until you put that, push on that lever.
So you don't think it has a transmission with gears in it? Like,
yeah,
faster
it does.
And slower?
And that's the tension for that belt. What's that? Let's see here. Oh, I see there's a belt right there that runs. Okay, I see. And then that runs the transmission. Okay. So.
That pulley's not even lined up.
You can't make that pulley back there any smaller.
Uh-huh.
You could make the one on top of the transfer case smaller. So let's see, do we have room to make a bigger pulley up here?
No.
Crap. You don't think so?
It's stuck slow forever.
No, it's not. Because we can take a torch and cut the bottom of that mount out. Let me think here. It'd be easier to leave that one because we're going to start cutting into the frame right here where the steering's all bolted to. We don't want to do that. All you gotta do is unbolt it right there and it unbolts off the shaft. And you pull that pulley down. So what we're gonna need to do, okay, we need to get the mower pulley stuff all out of here. Let me see how that's bolted in there. Onto this shaft right here. So let's take this bolt out right here.
Okay.
It's probably like a, looks like a half inch.
Okay.
Maybe 9/16.
Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and take the pulley out for the mowing deck assembly thing.
What the hell does that go to?
A shaft.
Okay, you gotta look in there behind the engine and see if you see a bolt turn in.
Yep.
Okay, we need to get a
rope. You can't get to it. There's no way you can get to it. There's no way.
Really?
Yeah. So you want to get the torch, we can just cut it out?
No.
Well, I guess that stuff won't hurt me in there. Let me find it again. I can't see it. Yeah. Can't get a wrench back there. You have to take the engine and the fuel tank out. No, you have to take the engine and the fuel tank out.
Can you point to it?
I can try. Stop. Okay, we got the wheel off. Okay, stop.
Took an hour and a half because it was rusted solid. Did you get it out or what?
Yeah, turn it.
Come on, Michael, help out over there, will you?
I can't move my fingers in there. It's not enough room. Okay. Okay, that's good. All Alright guys, that's going to be the video for today. Thank you so much for checking out this video. Don't forget to check out my Twitter, Instagram, links are in the description. If you're new, hit that big giant red subscribe button. And go ahead and subscribe to my channel. And hit that little bell, that little tiny bell. That thing's annoying. If you don't click that, you'll never be notified when I upload new content. You want that, I promise. So, like I said, if you're new, hit that subscribe button. And send me some fan mail. Leave questions down below for my family Q&A. Send me stuff for my P.O. box, you know. That's gonna be all. Don't get bored from this series. I know, like, right now it might be boring, but there's so much more stuff we're gonna do to the lawnmower. We're gonna do pulley swaps, horns, lights, alternators, you know, make trunks, all kinds of stuff. So, that'll be the video for today. Thank you guys so much for checking out my video. Peace.